For novice StarCraft players, you want a race that feels familiar yet has a wide range of effective strategies to choose from. You can't go wrong with the Terran. StarCraft II's human race strikes a nice balance between the powerful high-cost units of the Protoss and the low-cost swarms of the Zerg. It's also the most traditional RTS class, with mechanical buildings that you must construct and repair with your basic worker unit, the SCV. That doesn't mean Command & Conquer players will be able to dive right in and expect to win their first few matches. Let's start with base construction. The Terran race's mechanical structures are often modular, meaning you can modify them with powerful attachments that dramatically boost their usefulness. Your command center, for example, can be transformed via an upgrade into one of two buildings, an orbital command or a planetary fortress. Orbital commands give you access to powerful strategic tools like the scanner sweep, which lets you spy on your enemy's base from afar, the mule harvester, which temporarily boosts your mineral collection rate, and a supply drop that immediately increases the max number of units you can produce. The Planetary Fortress upgrade, meanwhile, equips your command center with a powerful cannon that deals respectable damage to enemy units. It's particularly useful for satellite bases that may not be as well protected as your main hub. Terran base building is also unique in that all of your unit-producing structures can lift off and move freely around the map. If you're attempting to relocate the better part of your base, it's usually an act of desperation. But that's not to say the ability is useless. See, the Terran's three combat structures, the barracks, the factory, and the starport, can all benefit from one of two attachments, a reactor or a tech lab. Reactors let you build two basic units at once, while tech labs give you access to more sophisticated units, along with an array of unit upgrades. And when you tell a structure with an attachment to lift off, the attachment stays behind. That allows you to reconfigure your unit production setup pretty much on the fly. If you spot a weakness in the enemy's air defenses, for example, you can drop a starport onto a reactor and start churning out Vikings at a moment's notice. Enough about buildings, though. This isn't SimCity, this is war, dammit! With the Terran race's medium-cost units, you have plenty of choices in how to approach combat. One particularly effective new unit in StarCraft II is the Reaper, a jetpack-wearing infantry type that can tear across the map at high speeds and leap over cliffs in a single bound. Catch an enemy off guard, and it's possible to destroy many of his harvesting units before he has a chance to react, drastically reducing his production capabilities. If you're envious of the Zerg's hordes but confused about how the race works, the Terran can employ a similar strategy as well. Build some barracks and starports with reactors, and you can quickly churn out Marines and Medivacs. As a Terran, Marines are your bread-and-butter combat unit. They're cheap, quick to produce, and able to fire at both air and ground units. And, with a couple upgrades from the tech lab, they're also pretty powerful. Stimpak, for example, lets you trigger a temporary boost to a unit's movement and attack speed at the expense of a small amount of health. Have an entire group of Marines Stimpak at once, and they'll pretty much lay waste to whatever you point them at. Medivacs, meanwhile, combine the functionality of the original StarCraft's dropship and medic units. Have them stay close to a pack of Marines, and they'll do their best to keep them top off. You'll still lose plenty of good men, but probably not nearly as many as the enemy, and that's what counts. If quick and cheap isn't your thing, though, don't defect to the Protoss just yet. The Terran can build a number of more advanced units with abilities that can quickly overpower an unprepared enemy. Take the Banshee, for instance, a new air-to-ground unit that can attack while cloaked. As long as you avoid detector units, you can put a lot of hurt on your opponent without him being able to retaliate. And if subtlety bores you, well, there's always Thor, a gargantuan mech with a Schwarzenegger impersonator for a pilot.
Thor is here!
Thors can attack both air and ground units, but they're especially effective at dealing with enemy flyers. They also have a large cannon that deals a ton of damage in a short period of time, and temporarily incapacitates their target. And if Banshees and Thors fail, well, there's always the old standby.
Nuclear launch detected.
Ah, it's like music to your ears. Unless your opponent happens to be Terran, in which case it's extremely terrifying and disheartening music. Nuclear launch detected. Like, let's say Night on Bald Mountain.
Nuclear launch detected. Nuclear launch detected.
It's getting too hot.